Halo, this is the latest Mega Bloks Halo Covenant Wraith Ambush set that features the new design of Wraith from Halo 5. Of course, I want to spend most of this video looking at and talking about the Wraith itself, so let me first get a little side build out of the way. And that's this. It's a terrain build with a bunch of alien looking purple foliage around, a little bit of a broken up vestige of a building. There's a missile turret that's hiding in there with the, I guess it's supposed to have come down in the requisition canister there. And then this is a broken up old mongoose, and I don't know if the intent is for the mongoose to have been taken out by the Wraith, or, you know, and then it's just kind of crashed into the bushes over here, or if this has been gone, you know, been broken up for a long time. But they actually, interestingly enough, put quite a lot into the build, the design of that piece of a mongoose. It's attached to the base very securely and properly with properly proportioned pieces, and they do give you extra pieces. These are not just sitting there, they're actually attached to the base, and those are enough to allow you to convert another mongoose over to this color scheme using that champagne marbled color of brick that's exclusive to Mega Bloks that I personally like quite a lot. So I really appreciate the fact that they included enough to finish everything off. If you want to do a conversion sort of like they did with the EVA's Last Stand with the Warthog, you know, they didn't give you a full Warthog there, but you could convert another one over to that color scheme. This is a lot of stuff just to be extras. The build of the Wraith itself was very enjoyable to me, and I believe it uses no new part molds, nothing new and exclusive to this set. I think that all of the parts already existed. They seemed all familiar to me. I didn't recognize anything new. However, it does have some exclusive prints for parts because they're not using stickers on these sets anymore at all. No stickers. So anything that looks printed, even towards the back that you don't normally see on the most, you know, camera friendly angles, that's printed. Got some printing up in here, got printing on the top of this thing even. And they're good quality prints too. I just like the level of detail on them, and they look really good. The thing goes together pretty well. It looks like it's kind of suspended in air back here, and normally that doesn't work in real life without having some kind of cheater pieces, but this has no cheater pieces whatsoever back here. It doesn't use repulsor lift technology. It's just balanced well enough to be able to hold itself up. So the pivot point is the rear pivot point is right about here. If you look on the underside of it, that's where you've got those clear inverted kind of round pieces that just allow this to slide around fairly easily on many different surfaces. That's your pivot point, and it's got just so much weight towards the front because it's a pretty solid build that it's able to stand up on its own just fine. I think that the shaping is good, not great. There are some iconic, very recognizable shaping elements to the new Wraith design in universe, you know, in game, that I think were missed here a little bit. I think that the nose, the center nose, could have been a little bit more bulbous, a little bit taller, and these side pods could have been a little bit more round, a little bit more built up in this section right here. That's what to me looks to be missing, because I feel like those front pods look like this. You know, there's a round convergence there, and it's very just curved around, and almost like a sphere that's been stretched out part way. And I think they kind of missed that a little bit. It just looks a little bit too blade-like to me, to my eyes, from everything that I've seen. And I've used these things a lot in game, and I've also come against them in game. And I think that there's just a little bit of miss of what my eyes want to see in the Halo 5 Wraith. But again, the build is good. They did get all of the key elements in here. I think that there's more detail than there needs to be with the actual shaping, especially back in this area, the center and the back, you know, a lot of angles that you don't normally see, I think, are just done exceptionally well and with just a lot of pieces, a lot of coverage. This doesn't have any angle from which it looks unfinished. You know, you look around here, let's take you down to a lower angle. You know, most of the time you're not gonna look at a model from down this low, but yet you can't see anything here that's bad. The worst thing that you see is the undersides of a couple plates up here for those side fins. You did notice that when I touched one of these side fins, it moved a little bit easily. That's one of the few bad things about this set. Just as you move it around, you know, you'll tend to run into that and just upset the position of it sometimes. It's just not a lot of friction in that particular joint there. But otherwise, looking pretty good to me, and just a real joy to put together and to see nothing that is exclusive, you know, nothing that is just for the Wraith. So you can always use all these parts to do other things. Now, the main plasma cannon is able to actually shoot. They have an old projectile system that's been reused here, and you just squeeze this. This is the trigger mechanism from the top. And they have a fairly proper colored projectile there that comes out with, and it's fairly large in size. And there we go. Just want to give it a good squeeze. And that's these. So, whoops, come back here. That's these. So you already saw some of those on the body of the thing, on the side. Four of those to spare, used just as detail on the outside, but you can actually load them up. So that's nice for play value for the younger kids who want to get into these things and want to actually be able to shoot something. It's a pretty good projectile, and you can aim it because you can, you know, fire this down. You can kind of bring it forward a little bit. And that's the one other thing that was bad in this, in the build. Another place where friction was a little bit limited was just right in that particular joint right there. I scored it a little bit. I need to score it just a little bit more to increase the friction in that particular part there. The other joint that brings the whole thing down is not so bad. These ones on the sides work just fine. And you can, the idea is that you can hide it all away and, you know, close that up. And that gives you, you know, the closed up, not ready to fire, just traveling around version of it, which looks a little bit more sleek, but also a lot more boring to me. So I think that very few people will actually keep it in that form for very long. So I would have been happy to accept a reduction of the accuracy of that design, just to get a little bit better friction, a little bit more sturdy of an assembly in here, maybe with an additional hinge used in there. Maybe if they had used two hinge pieces rather than that are one stud wide each, rather than one single piece that is two studs wide, it could have gotten just a little bit more grip in there. The gunner position is pretty good. It integrates well with an actual figure, which is increasingly tough these days with the figures being larger and, you know, having all the bulk of the armor on them. But you are able to squeeze a figure in there. You get the legs, you just kind of straighten them out and feed them down into there. There's plenty of hollow on the inside. You don't need to attach them with any peg in the back. You just set them in there and just grab on to the handlebars directly like that. This is able to be turned around, but it's a little bit tough to pull it off when you actually have a figure in there, just because of the limited amount of room there is. The cockpit area is hidden under here, and that does fit a figure as well. Another place that is tough to get into, but it will fit the figure. The toughest thing is just getting the head down far enough, because once this closes down, it's really, really tight in there with the space, but it does work. It does close all the way with a little bit of a snap kind of sound to it. He's got a couple of control sticks to hold on to. He does have enough room for his feet. And he also has two printed consoles, one on either side. So you see one over there, and then they use a different print for the one on this side. They could easily have done just a single print and just repeated the piece, but they didn't. So a nice additional extra little touch, and it all just fits right in there to the general shaping of the nose. The three figures included in the set are the Helljumper Spartan, which looks really good in that color scheme, I think. Just fits very nicely. And you see they officially put that character on Fireteam Stingray, with the emblem that's printed onto the shoulder, only on this shoulder, the left shoulder, not on the right. But that's nice that that small little emblem was actually printed on there, and they got a paint application for the knife as well. In the center is an elite commander, and on the right is just an elite miner. And those are not in the very brightest of silver colors that Megablocks has in their palette. It's the second brightest. The very brightest is the color they introduced with the Terminator Genesis line, and they use some of that brighter color in the build of the Wraith itself, down around the base and the sides and a little bit on the inside. This is just a little bit darker than that. It's the brightest color that they've used in the past. All of these look pretty good to me, and I'm happy with them, no complaints. They also include as extras in the set a target designator and a saw, and these are both in gunmetal gray. Pretty well done, I'd say. I wish that it was just a little bit more accurate with the shaping on the front of the thing, and I do wish that there was a little bit more friction in those few joints that I showed you that are a little bit loose. Otherwise, very happy with this thing. I think that the terrain, the little add-on terrain extra bits, are much more significant than I expected. I don't think they needed to have that much in there. I think it's a great unexpected bonus to be able to build another mongoose using the parts that are included here, just spare parts. Not to build an entire one, but to do an EVA's Last Stand style of conversion on one. So I look forward to trying that out just to add to my mongoose collection as well. And the figures here are good. I think that they're very usable, and I appreciate the extra accessories as well. I'm glad to see them going back to doing that. And I look forward to hearing your feedback about this set. Let me know what you think about it. Share your thoughts in a comment down below for myself to read and for other viewers to read as well. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. Stay tuned for more of my videos, because more are on the way very soon.